like so many people gather here, I think it's very clear that I'm not an innovator or part of a startup company, but I do have a small story to tell you. It's not a story about me, my journey, because I think that is just started. But it is a story of change and improvement, of inspiration and hope. In 2009, I came to this college. A student who wasn't doing very well in life. There was a student who wasn't doing very well in life. Academically, his CGPA was not to be envied at all. From one class to another, hours melted into days, days melted into months, and mediocrity for him had become a way of life. But then 4 years of constant failure, 4 years of learning the hard way, taking the hard lessons, going through it all, falling and bruising, getting up again, I have this opportunity to be standing in front of such esteemed people, and I'm trying to express my views in front of so many people gathered here. I'll start with BITS FC. The story starts with BITS FC. BITS FC was formed in 2010, with an objective to play in GFA 3rd Division Football League. Now this league, it consists of over 100 professional teams from all over the state of Goa. There are professional players, it's a very professional setup. The first year that we played, we got this opportunity, and the first year that we played, we were beaten badly. We were humiliated. There was no competition at all. In spite of the fact that we trained hard, we were humiliated by margins as high as 5-0, 7-1, and there was nothing to write back home, literally. So we were humiliated, we went back. But see, after this failure, one can take failure in two ways. The first option is to let it beat you, and the second option is to get back, look at it, learn from the mistakes and fight back. So we as a team resolved to do the latter. We had 1 year to prepare, so we took it in our stride, we went back, we worked on the mistakes, we analyzed everything, we trained harder. In spite of our academic commitments, we tried to do our best. Be it a holiday, Diwali or Holi, we trained every day without fail. We analyzed the mistakes. By the time the next tournament came, I felt that we were more focused as a team. We were definitely more determined, and I had this belief that we might this time around do better than the last time. As a captain, I invested a lot into this. I'm not talking about time or effort. I was emotionally invested in all of this. And at that point of time, I did not realize how this entire experience was shaping me as a person. So when this tournament started, the first game, we won the first game. And that was the start of an incredible journey. Winning, it always leads to motivation. And when we won the first game, we were motivated to perform better, to train harder. We did all of that. We subsequently won all our matches. And finally, the impossible. We did not even dare to believe that we could have qualified to the second division. We played the playoffs and we made it to the second division against professional players, professional coaches. So basically, without taking much of your time, what I want to tell you is that from my experience, from this entire experience, I learned two very important things. The first, which had been touched upon by our esteemed guests, that in the face of failure, we should not give up. You cannot lose hope, no matter what, be it academics, and I've been there, trust me, academics. Be it academics or football or anything for that matter in life, you cannot give up, you cannot lose hope, you have to fight back. Secondly, the most important thing is that if you're passionate about something, see, as students of BITS, I do not see myself pursuing a career in football. So it doesn't matter, even if you're in dramatics or music, and if you're passionate about something, I truly believe that you should stay committed to it, even if you're not going to pursue a career in it, because that adds meaning to life and it makes it extra special. That's it. Thank you for your time. Thank you.